What are we going to do about it? All right, I'm joined by Senator Jen Beck. Senator Beck has been a champion over the past couple weeks fighting this nonsense, standing up for you. Hey, Jen, good morning and welcome back to New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, good morning, Bill. How are you?
I'm all agitated this morning, Jen. I got to tell you, I woke up, I thought I was going to talk about my meal last night, you know, maybe a little bit of pork roll in the conversation, and then boom, I find out the tax could be as high as 37 and a half cents. Oh,
yep.
Come on. So what's going on today? What are we doing about it?
Today, we are going to do a roadside rally right near the Garden State Parkway on-ramp in Eatontown on Highway 36.
What's that, exit 105?
Yeah, it's exit 105, and we're going to be there with a big group of people just making sure commuters, as they go to work, are well aware that this vote is coming up as soon as Thursday. And
yeah.
That they've got to get involved and they've got to add their voices because it makes a difference. It really does. Legislators need to hear from them. This gas tax is $1.3 billion at least. That's the minimum.
That's the minimum. Yeah.
That's the minimum it is on our commuters. And, you know, we've got 7 million licensed New Jersey drivers in this state. It's a broad-based, regressive tax, and we can't take it. We've got to get our voices heard. So,
Jen, can I ask you, have you talked to Steve Oroho? I mean, you guys are colleagues. It's not like there are so many Republicans that you can avoid each other in Trenton, right? There are such a small number of Republicans in the legislature relative to the Democrats and looking, you know, compared to other states. What has he said to you, or is he not talking to you?
No, of course, we're colleagues. And, you know, his belief is that the rollback of the estate tax that is being tied to this is, you know, is a fine reason to go and raise the gas tax. And I tend to disagree. You know, you shouldn't be raising taxes to lower taxes. That doesn't make any sense at all.
Right.
And this tax affects 7 million people. I mean, we only have 9 million people in this state.
Right.
So 7 million, you know, 80% of people are going to pay this high gas tax because they got to drive to work and they have no choice. And it's more than $1 billion in a new tax.
And it's regardless of income. So, right. So what happens on Thursday? Now, the other thing I understand is in this bill, as the bill hits the floor or hits at least the committee where it'll go Thursday, there's no income tax deduction. That's gone. So even that little silver lining that someone could say, well, at least I could write it off, gone.
Yeah, I think there will be a lot of last minute changes. You know, United Airlines and the airlines at large are very, very concerned. This will make Newark International Airport one of the least competitive airports in the United States of America because of the cost it's going to impose on people that have to fly for their job. And so both drivers and those that also get to work other ways or have to travel a lot for work are going to be impacted. I mean, New Jersey should really be moving the other way. We need to be lowering taxes and being more competitive in the country, not raising taxes on people and forcing them to pay more.
I'm with you. All right. So, Senator, you can be joined today at 8 a.m. at exit 105, that on-ramp in Eatontown, where you will be there, and there'll be other folks there just to alert commuters that this is coming. And then what they can do to fight it.
Absolutely. And I encourage people to sign my petition, which you can find on 101.5's website. And also call your legislator. Take the time and do it. Let them know how you feel.
All right. Senator Jennifer Beck. Jen, thank you. I really appreciate it. Good luck today. Let's connect later this week as we continue this fight.